Yeah, you're looking sweet, darling. You got a baby, baby. Wish that I could love you back in a special way.
DJ Cream coming with all the slaps.
You like my mind.
I serve as the co-festival director of this year's Brave New Voices. If y'all feeling good, make some noise. If y'all feeling good, hit that chat. Yeah. Let me know if you feeling good, you feeling great, you feeling beautiful. Oh, my homie does this in Chicago, so I'm going to do this for y'all right now on the virtual screen. Make some noise if you're beautiful. Make some noise if you're ugly. Make some noise if you're blessed and highly favored. Yeah. Y'all, welcome to the first ever Black Opulence. Wow. Where we're centering all Black performers all day. We have an amazing lineup for y'all, and y'all are going to get touched, okay, on the spirit and the excellence, okay? You heard me? Excellence of Blackness, and that's big, period. Get your seat, head to your couch, get your auntie, mama, TT, Ray Ray, Poo Poo, Pookie Nell. Get all of them in the living room, and we're going to have us a good time. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about Black Opulence. Black Opulence is a showcase celebrating Blackness and the wealth and treasure our ancestors afforded us. Black festival, all participants will come and enjoy a curated night of Black excellence and storytelling through art. Artists of all mediums will showcase their incredible artistic offerings in a blackout like never before. Come see an intergenerational presentation of gorgeous Black talent and what we truly value and hold dear. These moments are necessary and intentional towards our collective fight for equity and anti-racist belief. Come witness the glimmer of this Blackness. Make some noise. Yeah. There we go, DJ Cream. Of course, we get that if we're in person, but we're all trying to practice social distancing to the best of our abilities and still offer you this space. But before we jump into this, let me take a step back. I'm so excited. If y'all can't tell, I'm going to take a step back. And before we jump into the show, I'm going to bring somebody up that's super, super, super dope in this game, actor, performer, all that amazing stuff that has a really beautiful message to y'all about why it's important to celebrate and center Black art and Black storytelling. I don't even got to say the name. I'm going to let the screen speak for itself. Y'all just make some noise for the incomparable. Yup. Here you go. Go check it out.
Hello. I just wanted to thank Darius for inviting me to here today. And to I'm so anxious to hear and to see and experience all of your wonderful talents. Just to reiterate how important it is to get your voice out there. We need you. We need all of your voices. We want to hear and experience everything that you have to say. Your voice today is so important in light of Black Lives Matter, in light of the climate that we're in politically, but we just need to hear from you. I want to hear you. And everything that you have to say is important. And I hope you understand the importance of being able to get it out there and the resonance of it. Because you are our leaders for tomorrow. And I need you, and I want to hear what you got to say. So congratulations for being here. Congratulations for participating. And I look forward to hearing everybody.
Wow. Thank you so much, Mr. David. Y'all make some noise for Mr. Keith David. One time, our forever pastor. So we're going to jump right into this show, y'all. Like I said, we're going to keep things going. Boom. Shout out to DJ Cream one more time. Down, down,
down. Cream coming with all the slaps.
Period. In this round, so I'm going to jump on and introduce two performers, jump off, let the performers do their thing, and I'm going to come back. It'll be a switch and a swap, okay? You hear me say switch? You hear me say swap? Switch, swap, all of this stuff. All right, cool. Boom. First up, V Armstrong and Shanika, make some noise. V is born and raised in Chicago, Illinois, has been singing professional since she was 15 years old, and has music available on all streaming platforms. V is about to change y'all life, I promise you. Boom, next up, we're going to hear from Shanika Madar, who's a first-generation American hailing from the island of St. Lucia. She is a poet, teaching artist, and community organizer. She believes in the power of narrative as a tool in the fight for transformation and justice. And just like Keith Davis said, Black Lives Matter. So make some noise for V Armstrong and Shanika Madar, y'all. Make some noise. Hit that check.
Thought I've really been real stressed, down and out, losing time, although I'm losing time.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring with the harmony of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening sky. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing the song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought. Facing the rising sun of a new day begun. Let us march on till victory is won.
Abby, how do you wash the trauma from your bones? Without been beats in my bushy, riding through the streets, spraying good vibes, I'm black and still alive. I can't believe it. The sun is still shining outside as though it is all fine. It has always been this way, and still it is strange. Greetings from Twin Died, the year of the COVID-19, the year someone put a torch to the Minnesota Police Department precinct 3, breath is something to be grateful for. Breath and shelter, breath and ginger and garlic and turmeric steaming in a pot at 2 a.m. in a global catastrophe. Thank God for the dancing and Beyonce's melodies and the wine in Mackel's hips and the song in Lauren's throat. Thank God for the softness boiling gives a sweet potato. In a year where Derek Chauvin suffocated us all, I've needed space to take pauses in. Because some of you wish to kill us. A lot of you are killing us. even behind your Black Lives Matter house signs, our red letter, Make America Great Again morals, behind your black face and bald head in solidarity is a self-serving apathy. Behind your takeover of a violent protest, a white savior complex that leaves us mourning children still, fathers still, mothers still, brothers still, but I did not come here to talk about nooses, not here for even three-fifths of a compromise. I'm here for reparations, because really, all jokes, all puns aside, the question is not if or why, but how you plan to pay us back. Alexa, play Bitch Better Have My Money by Rihanna.
Better Have My Money by Rihanna from Apple Music.
Alexa, pause. No, not the clean version. Not the version where bitch is implied. How you gonna pay us back for our grandmothers beating submission into our backsides? Alexa, pause. For the scars they know they would have to watch us carry on a cross or in the crosshairs of your streets or your school bells. How you gonna pay us back for our languages, the ones you don't know, our cornrows, our wide hips, our big lips, our bodies, your trends, our leaders, your t-shirts, dead heroes, our science, the arithmetic. Are you even doing the math? How you gonna pay us back for our culture? Not just the crowns you stole to make a slave, or the culture you stole from the belly of a slave in the belly of the slave ships. Not just the cultures you stole from the wombs of our aunties, our sisters, our cousins, Henrietta Lacks. Not just the cures you stole from our minds and our backs, or the culture you made vinyl so you could dance to it without having to see our faces. Still wanna call the cops every time we walk our dog or you hear hip hop playing. Yeah, before you beat us into a breakdown, I need the breakdown on how you plan to pay us back for the gold, the spices, the drum beats, the bodies, the jazz, the cotton, the reggae, the rock and roll. Not just the culture you stole from our pyramids, foraged in our coffins for, even the joy you steal, you owe us the debt we buy our coffins for. You should at least pay for the funerals when our skeletons pave your roads and line your mansions. Our bodies, our men, our women, arch our bodies into new debt, high blood pressure, bad health care. How you gonna pay us back with your money, our money? You reprinted without an ounce of an apology, imprinted with the very faces of the murderers. They're in print, still smiling. You know, in America, people can rarely place my island on a map. That's why I was livid to see St. Lucian, Botham Jean face on every network. In high school, after 3 weeks of sitting in her class, my white math teacher finds out I'm from an island. She asks, do you even speak English? Like a day in my life, I ever spoke to her in Creole outside of her native tongue or comfort zone. This is why I was livid to see St. Lucian Botham Jean face on every network shot by police officer. This is how you pay us back with insult to injury, constantly questioning our character like him, police training, got Breonna Taylor's shot in her house where she paid rent, even paid taxes for, bought gas, a uniform to go to work and pay taxes for freedom and safety and equal opportunity, right? Hours after they tell their mamas goodnight, like so many before them, white supremacy bust in their home, call them the intruder. With the same taxes they pay on rent, on living, put a search warrant on their living room. From heaven, I'm sure Botham knows these ledgers don't balance out. That man was an accountant. See, we all know the math is egregious. Bitch better have more than 40 acres and a mule. Bitch better have a Bentley. Bitch better have a college fund. Let's see, should we charge per ounce of blood or pound of lemon sinew? Per wrongful black imprisonment? Or can you pay for every time we've been harassed and brutally murdered by the police? For every unnecessary black death in a hospital? For every death by noose and tree? Bitch better have a penthouse. Bitch better own the Dow. This establishment can't pay us back for the then or the now. How you gonna pay my auntie back for every day she grieves the uninvestigated police murder of her son? For every day my brother spent burning for this country beneath a Middle Eastern sun to become home and be told, son, you can't stand into white boys? How you gonna pay me back for every day of blackness and opulence and grace I serve this sick, twisted, ancient, racist face of a society? Bitch better have my what? Bitch better drip in diamonds. Bitch better own the bank. When are you gonna stop incurring this debt? We know your system hides the devil beneath layers of bureaucracy, so the only revolution looks like burning every dollar with an inscription that makes a white man God and our bodies headline news. or not news, but we did not come here to talk about nooses. We want our reparations, fuck a Pell Grant and welfare, no stimulus check big enough, no discount for Black folks or Indigenous people to buy the hoax that this isn't all ours in the first place, carried here from Africa, just like them artifacts in your museums, right before we built these lands bareback with our own hands, hand over the keys. Our God's eyes are big, like sun and moon. Watch them wildfires catch in California. Watch a Trump administration turn America into petri dish before your eyes. This is the evil we've been fighting. Nowadays, we all scared for our lives. Oh, y'all realize rich people ain't worried about y'all at all. Black people are more used to this than tired and traumatized. Shame on you, white America. Since y'all plan everything, how you plan to make it right? Alexa, replay Bitch Better Have My Money by Rihanna. And not the clean version. Not the version where bitch is implied.
I'm going back to the South. I'm going back, 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 where my roots ain't watered down. Growing, growing like a baobab tree, all life on fertile ground. Ancestor put me on game, long time on gold chains, with my old shroom in a jail. Drip all on me.
Y'all make some noise for Shanika and V one more time. Shout out to my amazing, super dope, super beautiful DJ. I need to tell y'all about my DJ, so I'm gonna do that right now. Let's go, y'all. Let's go, y'all. Click yes, or type yes, or type heart eyes. Okay. Hey, we're in person. You know I'm used to call response in the audience, but we're gonna rock it out. DJ Cream is an Oakland native who is making a name for herself in the local scene with her signature genre mixing DJ style. After attending the Academy of Art in San Francisco and working various jobs, from visual merchandiser to nonprofit development fundraiser, Biju acted on one of her lifelong passions and turned it into art, and turned it into art form, never looking back. In 2016, Biju co-founded an Oakland-based music festival called Ocala, where she also made her DJ debut, curating tunes at the inaugural festival. Since her debut as DJ Cream, Biju has curated grooves at nightclubs, art receptions, weddings, day parties, and corporate events across the USA. Make some noise for my DJ. Y'all about to hear from two amazing, amazing artists. First up, Ugochukwu Nangi, aka Silk, is a 17-year-old Nigerian poet, rapper, visual artist, and social justice advocate. He loves using his art forms to address topical social issues, and he is an ambassador of Street Project Foundation Nigeria. Silk is currently preparing to go to university, and he wants to become a civil rights lawyer. Shout out to you, Silk, coming to us all the way from Abuja, Nigeria. Also on this round, you're here from the incomparable, my mentee, I have esteemed privilege of doing so, my mentee, Mr. Nathan Wallace. So y'all gonna see Silk and Nathan. Make some noise for them. Black excellence, Black opulence. We rock it all day. Make some noise in the comments. We'll see y'all soon.
Hold my hands, we gon' pray together. Lay down, face down in the gravel. Me wearing all tie white to the funeral. Black love, we gon' stay together. Curtain may feel on the speakers. Lil Malcolm, my mission, Mama Tina. Need another march, let me call Tamika. Need peace and reparation for my people. Fuck these ladies, just I'ma let it shrivel up. Fuck this fading ways, I'ma let it dread all up. Get your fist up in the air, show back up. Motherland, drip on me. Motherland, motherland, drip on me.
Hey. Yeah, sounds of the soul. Listen closely, ladies and gentlemen. S-I-L-C, vanity, vanity, vanity. That's what the world wanted to do to me. No clarity, clarity, clarity. Now you don't see what you're meant to see. They after me, after me, after me. All they want is my conformity. But actually, 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 I'm changing it from what it used to be. Yeah, vanity, vanity, vanity. That's what the world wanna do to me. No clarity, clarity, clarity. Now you don't see what you're meant to see. They after me, after me, after me. All they want is my conformity. But actually, 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 I'll never be what you want me to be, never. Vanity, vanity, vanity. Look what the world has done to you. We pay so much attention to irrelevant things. It's affected our system of value. From the senator to the lady selling crayfish right beside of you. We sow a poisonous seed in our minds, and we don't know the chicken is coming loose. Nowadays, no one wants to hear that. I am a man of simplicity. Please love sexism me. No one is feeling me because I look like a regular citizen. Oh, begins with little things. Go change that. Make a rapper what he meant to be. To defeat the cause that escort the senator and then the allowances. Huh. First of all, I'ma need you to explain why he's gotta be a him. We take from the white and take it a mile when it was only meant to be an inch. You live life knowing what does and does not matter in reality. You take the vanity. The Nigerians believe that that's how life was meant to be. Then people begin to do desperate things just because they wanna be like you and me. You forget about those living on the streets, those that are suffering. It's only me, yeah, it's only me. My name is only me and my family. And it's sad because that is the world we live in the 21st century. Yeah, vanity, vanity, vanity. That's what the world wanna do to me. No clarity, clarity, clarity. Now you don't see what you meant to see. They after me, after me, after me. All they want is my conformity. But actually, 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 I'm changing it from what it used to be. Yeah, vanity, vanity, vanity. That's what the world wanna do to me. No clarity, clarity, clarity. Now you don't see what you meant to see. They after me, after me, after me. All they want is my conformity. But actually, 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 I'll never be what you want me to be. Clothes, money, self-satisfaction, and most certainly power. Jewels, wealth, looks, pride, now they telling me about clout. I don't value these things, so they don't like me, wow. I don't do like they do, so they all want me out. We'll make a nation's decisions and then how selfishness pull me around. I don't wanna have to do the right thing and have society pulling me down. I don't wanna have to deny those that have values for real. I don't wanna live to have a fake life cause I wanna pay my bills. Listen, I don't know, but I think it's about time we revolutionize mentally. We need to change our values and perceptions of certain things. Cause unless we change all these about us, then most certainly we will still think the way we used to think, and then we won't end up changing anything. We focus on how things look like to others, and that is hypocrisy. Because instead of looking at the actual values, we focus on how will it profit me. If we don't change our value systems, then this is the place we will always be. I don't wanna sound religious, but hear ye, cause this is my prophecy. Yeah, vanity, vanity, vanity. That's what the world wanna do to me. No clarity, clarity, clarity. Now you don't see what you meant to see. They after me, after me, after me. But revolution is not being menacing. Cause actually, 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 revolution begins mentally. Vanity, vanity, vanity. That's what the world wanna do to me. No clarity, clarity, clarity. Now you don't see what you meant to see. They after me, after me, after me. But revolution is not being menacing. Cause actually, 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 revolution begins mentally.
Ain't about me, ain't about me. Gotta cook it up, cause my niggas hungry. Ain't about me, ain't about me. Gotta cook it up, cause my niggas hungry. Throw money in the air, can't drive too far. If I do black moves on call, ain't about me.
DJ Cream coming with all the slaps.
Now I'm changing the streets. Mama, I'ma break you off. Yeah, tell me what you need. I'm the new swap me. I told you I'ma break you off. I'ma break you off. Yeah, I'ma break you off. Everybody wanna break. They don't wanna pay the cost.
Y'all niggas cook, no need for prep. They just want mentions, I got the check. No need for wallet, don't pay for shit. Check the way a nigga from
ain't about me, gotta cook it up, cause my niggas hungry. Ain't about me, gotta cook it up, cause my niggas hungry.
Throw money in the air, can't drop the ball. If I do black moves on call, ain't about me. Ain't about me.
Today, all the black boys assumed their position on the block, wearing joggers like track shorts and white tees like jerseys. They be waiting, guns at the ready. They thought this would be a shootout, but no, this be a track race. The nigga who used to jump hurdles is a shooter now. I guess he found something good to use his speed for. Now, he is running up on the block, passing bullets like baton. From black boy, blowing out kids' brains from behind. He killed a boy and got arrested this week. This time the gun did not start a race, it started the marathon. It started the mourning of a humble hood, the grieving of unexpected people, and the police were on the block looking for him in less than an hour in track. Each race is ran different. On the 400, you must come out hard, stride the back stretch, and usually the last 200 yards is where niggas get caught. For this story, no one saw the shooter boy rise out the bushes like starting blocks. No one knew it would be a race until the black boy's body dropped. But by then, the shooter already had a considerable lead. But the funny thing about track and shootings in the daytime is that there's always witnesses, niggas that get to see you do the impossible. For him, the impossible was no longer winning state and hurdles. It was making it out of this hood alive. The streets was packed like stands today. And the neighborhood whispered your name as chalk filled the street. You knew the cops or some real niggas was gonna find you, but you still shot that boy. And that makes the second black boy shot and killed by other black boys in my city this year. But this is not the first time we have heard gunshots. Everybody comes to a track meet, but no one expects an injury. Everybody comes to a shootout, but can never predict the casualties. They exchange the track meet for swap meet. These track boys are becoming shotter boys. These hot boys are becoming dead boys. Niggas be wanting money and end up dying in their Gucci. Niggas be wanting to run the streets and end up running from it. Niggas can't tell the block from the track no more. When all they do is running to the money and with it, running to the streets and the city, running themselves into the ground. It's sad that these track boys have pulled 380s before hamstrings, because you can come back from a hamstring. You can wipe the fingerprints, even swallow the bullet shells, but nothing can erase the fact that you killed a black boy. And for that, you black boys that keep killing black boys are not welcome here.
Right foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. One hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Stop. Freeze! Everybody clap your hands. Right foot, let's stop. Left foot, let's stop.
Make some noise! Everybody clap your hands. Yes, DJ Cream giving very cookout vibes, very family reunion vibes, and that's why we're here. Black Opulence, period, to do that. Make some noise for Silk and Make the Wildest one more time. Thank y'all so much for sharing y'all stories. I'm gonna keep the show rolling. So in this round, you're going to hear from two amazing poets, Lyrical Faith and Sajari. Lyrical Faith, a Bronx native born and raised, she is a Black American educator, activist, and award-winning International Spoken Word poet. Through her poetry, she strives to inspire, educate, and advocate for intersectional and institutional issues by merging the arts and activism with a faith-based worldview. She is the founder of a public service organization known as Poetry for Service Incorporated, and a company, and a community of college educated artists known as Black Greek Poets, shout out BGP. You can find her frequent updates on Instagram at Lyrical Faith Poetry and Facebook at Lyrical Faith Poetry. Sajari Saltaviegas is a rising senior in Tisch School of the Arts, majoring in drama. He is also a Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. scholar and an award-winning poet, playwright, and actor from the west side of Chicago. Chicago, shout out. In his work, he investigates topics of social justice and identity from the perspective of a Black Sicken boy from Humboldt Park. He is committed to lifting up and acknowledging the often silenced voices of his people, and intent on entering the fields of TV, theater, and poetry while unapologetically pushing boundaries and telling his story. Y'all make some noise for Lyrical Faith and Sajari Saltaviegas. Make some noise, y'all.
Warner Brothers produced The Joker, and it becomes the first R-rated film of all time to gross over $1 billion in revenue. Transformers was set in Detroit. Red Dragon, filmed in Baltimore. The Silence of the Lambs was in Memphis, Tennessee. And Frankenstein came alive in New Orleans near the same field as 12 Years a Slave. These places all happen to be the most populous Black cities in America. The Joker was filmed in Newark, Jersey City, and the Bronx, New York. I am from the Bronx, born, raised, and I sound like, why am I so serious? But when tourists came to take pictures by the staircase, no one was laughing. I cannot enjoy a feature film without thinking of the unpaid extras posted on the block, how multi-billion dollar productions are shot in the hood for dramatic effect, setting up the horror as if we don't already know scared, like the black of our hands. I have seen chalk outline on sidewalk cleaned up in enough time for tour buses to pull up, because street signs in the ghetto make for such great action, like Compton, like Brooklyn, like nobody went to sightsee in the hood before it became Hollywood. Can't you see the stars in the ground? The ones that went to heaven before mama could say we made it, before the camera panned right down the graveyard to catch our good side. Tell me how many box offices will catch a tax break for the dreams that went to go die on Martin Luther King Boulevard. Which scene can my family survive in when our poverty is just so profitable, when the cameras stop rolling and remnants of your lens is still on every barbed wire fence movie magic? It's not how abandoned the buildings look, but rather just how well they edit out the residents. And somewhere, there are viewers visiting the finished products, capturing our trauma on portraits, posing in places they do not have to be a part of, thinking it'll turn out okay. Because isn't gentrification just color correction anyway? Black Lives Matter, y'all. I hope y'all out here exercising your First Amendment rights, because as the great Zora Neale Hurston said, if we are silent about our pain, they will kill us and say we enjoyed it. So, 7 lessons learned at the protest. 1. Let the white people get in front. Nah, dead ass. We know y'all wanted to be invited to the cookout, and praise God, this is the cookout. Can't you see the fire ablaze in the distance? Don't you smell the brown meat grilling? Hot, angry from years of being burned in the freezer, hungry from how long we've been left to rot. You asked for this upon building a cold shoulder to my existence upon our backs, damn right. This ain't a democracy unless you icing down with me. So yeah, allow your guilty tears to cover me like a picnic of guilty tears. It's the least you can do after showing up early and bringing nothing for decades. 2, if a black woman dies and there is no camera around to record, does it even make a tragedy? It's been over 4 months and still no arrest for the murder of Breonna Taylor, the murder of Rekia Boyd, the murder of Sandra Bland. The signs at the rally all read America's quarterbacks of martyrdom, as if we are not running through the same plantation as you gather in these streets to demand a play-by-play for equality. Please do not forget the soil that planted every seed. 3. It'll take a lot out of you. At the end of 7 miles, you will rattle in your bones. You will gloom in distress, knowing the war is far from over, knowing that we shall overcome, be several centuries away. Do you still walk? Do you take each step like a bomb ticking on the inside of your psyche? Conjure up ways to rationalize that this moment will be what my ancestors fought for and how my children will continue the fight. What if we never see liberation in our lifetimes? How do I live knowing my footsteps are just rehearsal to the performance of my eulogy? 4. The Birmingham movement lasted 37 days. The Freedom Rides lasted 7 months. The Greensboro sit-ins were 6 months. The Montgomery bus boycott was 382 days. Quit asking us when we will stop marching. We will stop marching when this country stops lynching us. 5. The soundtrack is Kendrick Lamar's All Right, NWA's Fuck the Police, YG and Nipsey Hussle's Fuck Donald Trump. The soundtrack is Nuck If You Buck, Tupac's Keep Your Head Up, and for the Saints, Tasha Cobb's Break Every Chain. Revolution by Kirk Franklin, we gonna praise while we dance in these streets, shout Negro spirituals to the top of our lungs, and in demand, you put some respect on our peace. Six, come prepared, bring milk for the tear gas. Bring a thick shed of skin for the rubber bullets. Bring a pair of shoes you do not mind creasing. Move like your body is on fire. So instead of the precinct or the cop car, it was actually just every breath you ever took. Dragon balled its way up your throat and out onto the threatening. We told you this is the cookout. How could you not expect for there to be flames? Seven, you wanted an invite so bad, right? Here it is. Don't walk up empty-handed and expect us to still fix you a plate.
There are only two sides to the theory of dark matter. Either you believe it exists or you ignore its existence by saying all matter matters. My theory is that dark matter exists everywhere, within solids, liquids, and gases. Phase form solid, stolen in solitary, sturdy enough to keep this country in its economic element. Our nuclei fill up the most cells. Solids have the ability to resist forces applied either perpendicular or parallel. But handcuffs come in orbits. And when we resist, ain't no telling in which directions the bullets fly. So we pamper and get pretty till we bullet fly. Ask why we sit with solidity during the national anthem. Well, if we stand for the country that kills us, wouldn't this technically be a suicide? Phase form liquid. Our water gives you mountainside purified and you spit it back, flint formed and frugal. Give you another metaphor about slaves and the ocean, and you still send great whites to come on this stage and drown us in our own saliva. Still send great whites to come on this Zoom and drown us in our stolen saliva. When liquid is poured onto a plate, the shape changes, but the volume stays the same. When a dark matter mother's water breaks, the volume of the baby's the volume of the baby's innocence instantly changes. Black wombs deserve a Nobel Prize, for they are the first to discover the theory of birthing invisible substances. Phase form gas. So many of us turn into carbon dioxide at the hands of crooked chemists. Funny we can't breathe, considering we are the CO2. Your favorite disappearance act, the only ones who can phase change between hashtags and hocus pocus. Can you see the dark matter festering in every phase? Bleeding from the protons and electrons that say we don't exist? The problem is not that dark matter is a controversial theory. The problem is that people are still acting like dark matter is a theory we still need to prove. All history starts with dark matter. There is no white or light without it. Just because we don't radiate electromagnetic light doesn't mean we aren't luminous and present. Stop searching for evidence beyond the stars. You don't need a spaceship to reach dark matter. Europeans used a boat to do that years ago. You don't need NASA to navigate the Negro. Our existence isn't rocket science. Today, dark matters. Today, dark matters. Today, dark matters. Thank you.
Black, 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 black. Black on black, black. Yeah. Hey, okay.
DJ Cream coming with all the slaps.
Black on black, my skin is so black, I'm rocking that black on black is black.
Black rims on this black, wheels in this black, black with this black bitch. So black on black on black on black on
black, 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 black on black, black, my thoughts so black, black, black on black, my skin is so black, I'm rocking all black, everything is black.
Rims on this black, wheels in this black, black with this black.
Period. Make some noise for Lil Faith. It's a Chari. One more time. Wow. The poems, performances have been so amazing. If y'all are just tuning in, we are here for the first ever Black Opulence presented by Brave New Voices. DJ Cream, get it for me. There we go. Yay, all that. I'm your host, MC, all the good stuff for the evening. I'm about to bring up two more amazing poets. So if y'all ready, say yeah. If y'all feeling good, say yeah. When I say black lives, y'all say matter. Black lives, black lives. When I say black lives, y'all say matter. Black lives, louder in the comments. Boom. Next up, we're going to hear from Nanel and Slankston Hughes, y'all. Ooh, that one's for a treat. Former Atlanta Youth Poet Laureate, Nanel McKay is a Jamaican-American Southerner, writer, actress, and Black mental health advocate. Immensely grateful for her beginning in the arts of the youth. As an adult, McKay has refined her approach to the craft by utilizing her content as a method to educate onlookers with the intent to destigmatize mental health in the Black community. Shout out to Nanel. Slankston Hughes, Baltimore, Maryland, he, him, his. Slankston Hughes is a national slam champion based out of Baltimore, Maryland, artistic director of Do More Baltimore, and author of the poetry collection, Slanguage Arts and Griot Glimpses. Y'all make some noise. Show all the love. Blow up the comments from Nanel McKay and Slankston Hughes. Let's do it.
I have two poems. One, looters cannot be looted. All toddlers go through a possessive phase, but white children become white adults who never grew out of sane mind. When Joe Biden parted his veneers like a killer whale opening up to swallow Charlemagne, he said, "You ain't black if you vote for Trump." What he meant was, if you are in support of my competitor, you are someone else's slave. This was not the first time a white man took us by surprise. If you've seen the film Amistad, you'd know. White people don't read the room. They shoplift the humans inside of the room. Therefore, looting looters cannot be determined as theft. Looting looters is how my niggas attempt to embezzle themselves back. Sir out of his cotton picking mind if he thinks he's gonna rob us of us and we ain't supposed to burglarize the city. Arrest us for coming to collect what has always been ours and watch how our grandmamas pray us out of your prisons. How my partner them go fund me free. All y'all have is because we would not die and y'all called us roaches for surviving you. You, the supreme greed, the wealthy apocalypse deserving of bankruptcy, and we are the height you never saw coming. The force that forces forefathers to turn over in their grave. Our mothers told us not to touch a motherfucking thing in the store, although we weren't the ones with sticky fingers. This is not looting. This is the stick up our ancestors were waiting for. This is what happens when you promise a tortured people 40 acres and a mule, then ghost them like a bad date when the car declines. Stop wasting oxygen, apologizing for debts and deaths. You are not willing to foot the bill, America. We tried being civil, right? Now it's love and light that shit up. I'm gonna move on to my second poem. It's untitled. According to Merriam-Webster, the definition of hell is A, another world in which the dead continue to exist, B, a place or state of misery, torment, or wickedness. I am impatiently waiting at God's clock for a white person to tell me to go to hell again. I demand to be given a second chance at the truth. I demand to be given a reason to beat my chest as the words, "I'm already there," shoot like stray bullets out of my gun chamber mouth. I beg of you, tell me to go back to my country, not in a Delta Rewards member round trip flight kind of way, but in a wall building Trump supporter kind of way. Please bless me with a bigot in the reddest hat and the opportunity to ask them, which country are you referring to exactly? The one I was brutally bullied into building until I bled quarts of wilting roses, or the one I was excavated from like a traffic diamond. There came a point where I was not certain if I was born this bronze or if my char derived from broiling inside of America's oven to hell with being told to go to hell. That statement implies it is a place I have never been, when in fact, hell is a condominium, fully furnished and always blazing, because sometimes you have to decorate damnation to remind yourself you deserve something holy to look at. Instead of giving in to the flames, we have found smarter ways to stay cool. We accessorize the hell out of hell to soften the heat waves. We design living rooms within the systems that want to roll our credits. We outlive this horror film by anticipating the jump scares. Black folks are the foster kids of all folks. To have a parent country and to simultaneously not have a parent country is its own inferno. But ain't it like us? To beatbox in the belly of the serpent that seduced Eve and never completely submit to the idea we are without song. For most, heaven is a holy happening that occurs after death, but for us, it is wherever we show up. And so, no matter the lava or the lynchings, the table will be made and Sunday dinner will be on it. Thank you all.
Powerful people cannot afford to educate the people who they oppress. Because once you are truly educated, you will not ask for power. You will take it. Slave him in your stomach. Broken Bible verse in your pocket. The watch that watches time like the red line riding towards your heartbeat. The stolen overpriced soul that you can't get back, played back on repeat. Barcodes branded on newborn babies' birth certificates. There's a price selling your life's worth, selling yourself back to yourself before you can download your self-worth. There was an app that interacts with your melanin, but you gotta die first. There's dirt in my dialogue and a callus on my soul, scratching at the infection like a mad turntable is a bloody crucifix carved in our fingerprints. Because Lord knows as soon as the cock crows, they will take hold and siphon the God out of your dick. Fuck you. And fuck them too. I am Jesus at a peaceful protest, fully strapped. I am John Brown posting pics on Instagram of free slaves being sold back. I'm Harriet Tubman in the club making it clap. I am Imhotep on crack. I am your worst nightmare because I don't know who I am, but I know how the I am. A biracial binary baby with an iPhone plugged into his navel, keeping Africa fully charged, only get charged double for the cost of my life back and catch a charge from those who charged with no rights, see damn right, even my rights to write back, nigga. Frederick Douglass ain't need Twitter. You could be Trayvon Martin, Delaney King, and still not be accustomed to the hood you in. They put Christ in a hood and let the media crucify the spin. So when the zealots was finished yelling, we remain equally unaware of the blood spilling in the linen and the lineage of the hood you in. So if you brown, six shots will put you down for the count, because your very skin is a threat to the world you in. You can't be in the struggle and not struggle. I guess the griot is back with the vengeance. White guilt had sex with white privilege and produced assimilated niggas. There's a railroad of bones at the bottom of the ocean. There's a chamber of souls and the guns our sons are holding. There's a loud graveyard planted beneath every American city. You thought the zombie apocalypse was some shit? Just wait until you get a hold of my niggas. See, this is the dispensation of truth in the new age, and there's so many slain ancestors coming back for revenge that'll make reparations look like minimum wage. No justice, no peace, but I will scream justice in this peace if it's just us in this peace. But don't expect no just us once we take to the streets. Black lives don't matter. Black lives are matter. Like space, like stars, melanin and shit. Matter. Nigga, naturally intellectual ghetto galactic alchemist. Nigga. But sometimes I wonder if it all really matters. When I hear the devil's laughter, and if dreams are just nightmares that heaven shattered. A wise man once told me, the black man is God. If God looked into a mirror, and the mirror shattered. So, a few days ago, I traveled to the future where I met a black baby who glowed in the dark. When I asked them how, the child didn't speak, but handed me a smile inside of a notebook that read the following. Black light. Noun. The resilience and brilliance of Black people managing to stay alive while simultaneously bringing brightness to an often dark world that knows only how to hate you. I heard Black joy is the substance left over after Black rage melts away. After our capacity to love endlessly punches white supremacy in the face. Correction, Black joy is the ability to punch white supremacy in the face. It's what happens when both patience and paranoia run out. Have you ever seen a classroom configure into a courthouse? A church steeple fold in on its people? Prayers and eulogies have become synonymous on our tongue. I guess poetry really don't save lives. The way we go from bassinet to body bag in the blink of an eye, the thin line between hands up, don't shoot, and praise God, I'm coming home. It ain't that we got soul, but rather we live so close to death that ours is always showing. Like the way we hung from trees wasn't proof that Jesus was one of us. How even God's son was murdered by the state in a public execution, like the crucifixion wasn't the first lynching, or how art as activism isn't a decision, but rather a birthright. But democracy has always been a dead body propped up at the party, where everybody feeds off its rotting flesh, an old orgy of the worst kind, where the poor and the dying get fucked every time. You ever notice how America and necrophilia rhymes? And so many POCs wanna try and ignore their hue. Like they DNA ain't saturated in middle passage just like me and you. Like slave ports didn't exist all throughout the Caribbean. Like colonizers didn't rape indigenous tribes and create Latin Americans as if ain't ripped 3/5 of us from Africa's shores and hyphenate the remains. But colorblind just means you're not looking. You don't see race because you won't acknowledge my face. The same way you won't look beneath Trayvon's hood or inside Emmett's coffin. This was supposed to be my Black joy poem. And nigga, it is. Because despite all the metaphors mangled with murder and all the poplar tree imagery in the poetry, our resilience radiates infinitely. Our laughter, a survival tactic that will literally move us across the room. Why do you think our humor is so dark, our art so bloody, our tears so cleansing, a sacrifice of sacred energy keeping us living? You ever notice how a hug can often be the most powerful form of protest? Black joy is everywhere, from my great grandmother's enchanting stare to Black children with hair that treats gravity like that shit ain't even there. And I've seen Black light sparking and leaping into existence, the playlist of resistance and ancient rhythm, alchemy and bass blending, like Erica Bridgeford transforming a crime scene into a sacred space, knowing that death is not a thing except a door that needs to be opened to let the music out, like an old man bending himself into an infant that glows in the dark.
Never could have made it without you. Never.
Coming with all of us.
So we want to make sure that y'all see everybody. Next up to the screen is an amazing artist, y'all, an amazing songstress that we're about to bring up. Guapale is urging social change and boldly standing up for righteousness in the face of inequality. In the next, she's guiding her child with a sensitive and understanding, hard-earned wisdom, and unconditional love. In between, she's as soulful as ever, This delicate sonic shape-shifting is a technique she introduced on her now classic 2001 debut Closer, but she honed it to perfection on Dream Seeker. That diversity has defined the Oakland-born singer, songwriter, producer, actress, and designer since the start of her career in 2001. Her influence and impact can be felt throughout R&B, soul, and hip-hop. Even Closer yielded the iconic anthem Closer. To date, it's impressively racked up over 8 million Spotify streams. In between touring the world, she has released 5 albums and collaborated with a diverse array of heavy hitters such as Snoop Dogg, E-40, Eric Benet, Soul Live, and Jeff Baxter. A film and television mainstay, she's landed high-profile sinks in Sparkle, Honey, 90210, and many more. The Washington Post fittingly described her as soulful as always. Huffington Post called her a driving motivational force for many women. In essence, claimed her voice is the stuff of dreams. Wobble has expanded her creative outlet into film, executive producing, and starring in the art noir experimental short film, hashtag Where's Beauty. With social media playing a huge part in our lives, the film addresses society's obsession with selfies while following the journey of a woman challenging her followers to dig deeper and appreciating that true beauty exists within us. That's beautiful, y'all. Thank you so much for that. Outside of music and entertainment, Wobble has aligned herself with community leaders to support the calling for social justice awareness. Working with Common and the Imagine Justice Organization, a New Way of Life Foundation, and her continued work with the Agape Spiritual Center. Within the past year, Wobble has built out her lifestyle brand, Dream Seeker, collaborating with emerging designer, Miu Collective, on the eco-friendly, unisex, limited edition, athleisure line, with a zero-waste philosophy. Most recently, Wobble has focused on broadening her platform by hosting the Closer Conversation Series on IG Live, where she interviews her most inspirational friends in entertainment and activism as they talk about passion, purpose, and the journey. Wobble is currently recording her 6th album slated to release later this year. Y'all make some noise, show all the love, react in the comments for Wobble.
Hi, my name is Guapale, and it's an honor to be here with you for the Black Opulence event with the Kennedy Center and this whole couch series. I think that art and music is one of the things that's getting us through this pandemic and keeping us uplifted through this movement of Black Lives Matter throughout the globe. This song is about the transformation that's still to come. I'm getting higher, closer to my dreams. I'm getting higher and higher. I can feel it in my I'm going higher and higher, and I can almost reach. I'm going higher, higher, and moving upwards and onwards and beyond all that I can see. I'm going higher, higher. I'm going higher and higher. Oh. I'm going higher and higher, higher and higher, higher and higher. Moving upwards and onwards and beyond all that I can see. Oh. Sometimes it feels like you'll never grow a change. Oh. But I'll never choose to.
We are so grateful to have you part of Black Opulence. Yeah, so before we head out, I'm going to bring up another special performer, someone who I know and love and appreciate in this work and in this community. I want y'all to make some noise. Let me. I'll be accompanied by this super talented, you saw her earlier, V. Armstrong. V, where you at? Where you at, baby?
I'm here.
How you doing?
How you doing?
I'm doing good. When I say Black Lives, y'all say Matter. Black Lives, Black Lives. When I say Black Lives, y'all say Matter. Black Lives, Black Lives.
Wade in the water. Wade in the water. Children wade.
Be free.
In the water.
Waters.
God's gonna trouble the water.
Of the struggle of my people not good enough for you, or the way they pick cotton not intriguing enough, or the way they endure hours of lashes of fire on their backs and all to their families at night. Tell me, is my fucking history boring? Was my black offensive? Those 28 days in February is all some of us got. My ancestors have bled on your America's flag long after slavery, suffocating beneath red waters we're waving, on hands and feet, riding our history on waves, carrying our lineage on backs. You see bullets bounce between ocean currents like little passages, like black boys floating in pools of blood. I'm the blood and sweat of my ancestors seeped into this soil that's produced the strangest of fruit. I'm sandcastles built on concrete, because concrete can't seem to stand sand anymore. Just like America can't seem to stand those black boys anymore. Like guns in the hand of black boys and black girls, and black boys and black girls, they see no difference. They see black, they see color, they see no difference. Carter G. Brooks created Black History Week as a means to give credit to the diligence, one of the bones of my people. A confirmation that invention and innovation isn't just a white thing, and that my melon was good for something more than collard greens and fried chicken. I'm the fight, and Martin's voice the rage, and Malcolm's power militant, like Fred Hampton Cunning, like Harriet Brand, like Rosa, set the fuck up, like you, like me, of this country and its injustice. My people are strong, And I'm still stuck trying to connect dots of blood and bone, wondering why true history even is of being black. Is even real what's black, what is real, I'm African. The Nile River is pumping through my veins. I'm Ghanaian, Sudanese, I'm Kenyan, Egyptian, Moroccan, Somalian. I'm the scriptures they lost at sea. I'm waiting amongst all these waters. Waiting. Forever waiting. Wondering. God is
going to
trouble
them. Wade in the water. Wade in the water. Wade in the water. God's going to trouble.
Black lives matter. Black trans lives matter. Black queer lives matter. Say a name, Breonna Taylor. Say a name, Ahmaud Arbery. Say a name, George Floyd. Say a name, Nina Pop. Say a name, Tony McDade. Say a name. Black lives matter. Will always matter. Thank y'all so much for tuning in to the first ever Black Opulence, hosted by Brave New Voices. Thank you so much to the Kennedy Center, to all of our partners that are tuned in. We rocking out with DJ Cream. Ashe, Ashe. Thank you so much, B. Ashe, take care of yourselves. Black Lives Matter. That's big, period. All right.
DJ Cream coming with all the slaps.
We've been hurt, been down before. When our pride was low, looking at the world like, where do we go? And we hate po-po, wanna kill us dead in the streets for show. I'm at the preacher's door, my knees get weak and my gun might blow, but we gon' be All right, my name is Roya Marsh, and I am a Black poet who would not remain silent while this nation continues to murder Black people. I have a right to be angry. I have a right to be joyful. And Black joy is real. It's native, not white. It was here before that, before God said, let there be light, so they could witness a glimpse of what they've been missing. Black is not a color, but absorbs all the colors of the visible spectrum and reflects none. Joy is a feeling of great pleasure or happiness. Black joy looks like me, like him or her or them. It knows no gender, just knows prosperity in spite of white supremacy. Black joy is a stone worthy of digging, of excavating, a coveted jewel to be held up to light, to sparkle, to dazzle. Black joy knows this poem is necessary no matter what your judgment says, because you can't tell me Black joy won't break any scale you put it on, shit. You can't tell me Black joy ain't the scale itself. Black joy is contagious, so contagious, folks got caught appropriating, caught pinning Black against Black, or Joy against Joy, or Remy against Nikki, or Cardi against Nikki, or Ree against B, or Kobe against LeBron, or LeBron against Michael, because healthy, wealthy Black folks just got too close to God, and they only want to see us Black and joyous if they made us that way. That they cannot create Black joy the same way they created race. They cannot dictate our Blackness. They cannot dictate our happiness. And yeah, it's true. Once you go Black joy, you'll never go back. Ask the Kardashians or Rachel Dolezal, those Black olds. Make a staple of Blackness. Remember, Black and happy can be synonymous. So whenever you hear the word Black, instead, hear happy. Case in point. In 2016, we bid farewell to this nation's first happy president. February will now and forever be known as Happy History Month. Hollywood still won't cast happy people to play our happy selves, and yet another happy body is found slain. All the more reason to preserve this shield, this force field of fortune, no hot commodity to be bought or bootlegged or Kylie lip kit backshot brainwashed. Be your happiest when your mouth is open. Be your Blackest when your mouth is open. Shout it for Black opulence. Shout Black, shout joy. You remember, white supremacy is a beast that feeds on attention. Be happier, be hungrier, starve it, leave it nothing but the bones. Thank you.
Bad, but you forget wrong. Skin. Oh, baby, just to get down.
DJ Cream coming with all the slaps.
Bad, but you forget wrong. Oh, baby, just to get down. If you know just what you're starting,